Our pre-crystallized chocolate is ready for use. Now let's pour it into our molds. First, we have to check whether the molds are squeaky clean. There shouldn't be any traces of previous fillings. If this is the case, then first clean out your mold again. There should not be any fingerprints in the molds. Every time you use this mold to pour a praline, you'll always find that same fingerprint in the same place. Now the molds have to be preheated. Why? If we use a mold that's too cold, the chocolate will cool down too fast. This will result in dull spots on the surface or stains due to refrigeration. The mold has been preheated. Now we'll pour chocolate into it. Hold the mold at an angle and pour until it's full. The chocolate will only run down one side, which means we'll only have to clean one side. Now this mold has to be swished as soon as possible in order to eliminate any air bubbles. As soon as you're sure that all the air bubbles have been eliminated, turn over the mold and remove any excess chocolate with a turning motion. The bottom of the praline is carefully scraped. You should also check whether the density of the coating shell is perfect. A coating shell that's too thin is not nice to look at. What's more, if the coating shell is too thin, you'll not be able to unmold the chocolate properly. Now you can place the mold on paper or on a rack. What's the difference? On paper, you'll always obtain a stronger edge, which is always an advantage when sealing your praline. There's one huge disadvantage. If the workspace in which you're working is too hot, you'll lock in the warmth, resulting in a slow cooling. The outcome? Your chocolate will go gray. In that case, you're better off using a rack as it has air circulation underneath. A small disadvantage of this system is that if you leave the mold out for too long, the chocolate hardens and will stick to the rack. As you remove it, pieces will break off, which we'll have to repair with our fingers and then with liquid chocolate. 5 minutes have passed. As soon as the molds come off the paper, we'll scrape them off and immediately place them in the refrigerator. You'll need to do this immediately because if the chocolate cools down too slowly, you'll have a bad end result. The chocolate will turn gray. Also, check the temperature of your fridge. Never too cold, between 8 and 10 degrees Celsius is perfect. Always ensure good ventilation and heat elimination. Make sure the molds are not stacked on top of one another, that they're placed at a sufficient distance from each other, and that air circulation is possible.